This is Marvelous Light of God Ministry. My name is Pastor John. Then you are welcome tonight for another day of program. The Lord bless you so much. I appreciate all of you that have been following us, watching the program, watching what God is doing in the Marvelous Light of God Ministry. Therefore, tonight, I appreciate your presence in this program again. I want all of you to pay attention that the Lord is going to bless you once again. This is the month of October. And this is the month of October, the 10th month of the year 2018. The Lord is going to do a great thing this time. Yes, maybe you people don't understand why the Lord make it this way. But after today's program, you will realize why the Lord make it in this way, in Jesus' name. And at the same time, I want to remind you that we have a coming program that's going to take place 10th of October, this time, 10th of October this month, to 14th of October. So we're going to start it every evening by 6 o'clock in the evening. Start by 6 o'clock in the evening and close by 9 p.m. in the evening. So on Sunday service is going to be dedication and thanksgiving service. And we're going to receive a man of God here coming from Nigeria. He's a guest speaker, Pastor Joseph Idiaboya. The Lord is using him mightily in Nigeria. We're moving all over the world, America, London, England, everywhere. I think this time is our own turn to receive him. I've been requesting for him to come here for so long, but have given me that no chance, no opportunity, but this is our time. Please, wherever you are, don't miss this opportunity. Even though you are in Valencia, even though you are in Madrid, bought your ticket and try to join this program, the Lord will bless you mightily. And the topic of this program is say, lose him, let him go. I don't know. Whatever they have been tied somewhere, maybe they tied you in a shrine, or they tied you in the body of a river, tied you somewhere, tied you in people's heart. Whatever they tied you, the Lord is using him mightily because of this message, because of this topic. It's a special design by God. Lose him, let him go. But when you come, you will see what I'm telling you. Because the last time the man visited this place, it was wonderful. Ask so many people that live here in power, they will tell you that the Lord used him greatly. And many souls were delivered. And miracles, signs and wonders took place in his ministration. So I want you to come and be blessed. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Now remember, the topic of today's program is, it shall not stand. It shall not stand. What is it shall not stand? I want to explain to you what is it shall not stand. But before that, let us pray. Father, we thank you tonight. We bless your name, we give you praise and honor, magnify your majesty. Jehovah Shaddai, I pray tonight, as many that are watching this program will never remain the same. Every problem that I've been assigned from focus of this world to look for their life, it will never stand. Neither shall it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Therefore, Father, tonight I declare that all the evil decree over their life, many that are watching this program, all the evil decree over their life shall not stand. All the curses shall not stand. Satanic opposition shall not stand. All the negative thought of men and women over their life shall not stand. All the evil declaration over their business, over their investment, over their children shall not stand. Because the Bible says, who is he that is saying it come to pass when the Lord have not commanded it? The thought of God concerning you is not of evil, but it's of good to meet your expected end. Therefore, for this reason tonight, every evil pronounce, every evil declare, whatever any man or woman have decided over your life for you to suffer, for you to be reproached this time, it will never stand. Neither shall it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. And they are watching, oh God, bless them. And those that are watching through television, through this television, through YouTube, wherever they are watching it. Therefore, as the Bible said, as they watch, the Lord is going to bless them mightily. They are going to surprise you at this time. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And welcome once again to the topic. As I said, he said it shall not stand. But let's go through the Bible and see what the Lord has for us. The book of Isaiah chapter 7. The book of Isaiah chapter 7 from verse 6. Let us go up against Judah and vex it. And let us make a bridge therein for us, and set a king in the midst of it, even the son of Tamar. But Bible says from verse 7, thus says the Lord God, it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. So what am I talking about? You may decide to do a business. You may decide to organize a business you want to do. You organize a traveling you want to do. You want to travel to another country or to another city or to another town. You want to build a house. You want to start a project. You want to start one thing or the other. And the Bible says, surely, that's the word of God. Isaiah 54 verse 15. It says, surely, they will surely gather. But the gathering is not of God, they will scatter. And the Bible says, my thought towards that your program is not of evil, but to meet the expected end. And the Bible says, the book of Psalm 35 from verse 27, I take pleasure when my people are prospering. God is taking pleasure when you are building a house. God takes pleasure when you are starting a project. God takes pleasure when you are when you are traveling. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 49 verse 11, I exalt highway for my people to travel. So if you want to make a journey, God is interested. God is happy when you are making a journey. That's what the Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 2. Rise up and take a journey. Even when you are in one place, God says, rise up. So what am I talking about? Any conspiracy of any type to come and stand on your way this October, the Bible says it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. I declare over your life this time that no evil shall stand over your way, no witches shall stand over your way. The Bible says, the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 7, it said they will come against you in one way, but they will scatter seven ways. This is the promise of God over your life. This month of October, you never remain the same. I decree over your life this time that the Bible declare over your life that it will never stand. No evil shall stand over your life. Because this is what they did in the time of Moses. I'm going to take you through the Bible for you to understand what I'm talking about tonight. That you see that the Lord is going to make sure that this month you will enjoy it. Because it's a month that God can never forget. It's generation to generation. God always remembers the 10th month of the year. Therefore, I'm going through the Bible. The Bible says, thus says the Lord, the book of Isaiah chapter 7, from verse 7. It shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. For the head of Syria is Damascus, and the head of Damascus is risen. And with the threescore and 5 years shall Ephraim be broken. Verse 9. And the head of Ephraim is Samaria, and the head of Samaria is Ramassan's son. If you will not believe, surely it shall not be established. Whatever evil you don't believe this month cannot be established unto you. Why? Because the Bible says it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. Therefore, anything anybody declared over your life, as long as you don't believe it, it shall not stand. That is the word of God. The book of Isaiah chapter 7 from verse 9. It said, surely, if you don't believe any evil anybody said over your life this month, it shall not be established. Because the Bible said, can two walk together except they agree? And the Bible said, if two of you shall agree, touching what they requested, the young age shall be established by my Father, which is in heaven. So any man or woman, which is a wizard, part of forces of darkness, open their mouth to say any evil over your life this month, if you don't believe it, don't worry about what anybody said. Don't worry about what the people pronounce over their mouth. Don't care what they said over their mouth. But the Bible says, if you don't believe it, it shall not be established unto you. Therefore, for this reason, every evil that will be programmed or projected over your life today, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, as you are hearing this message, it will never stand, neither shall it come to pass. Only be that strong in prayer this month. Only be strong in prayer this month.
The Lord will change your situation. The Lord will answer your prayer. Excuse me. The Lord is going to fight your battle this month in the name of Jesus. Now listen, let's go to the Bible. Let's go again. The book of Numbers. Let's go to the book of Numbers. Book of Numbers, chapter 14. Chapter 14 from verse 1. All the congregation lifted up their voice and cried. And the people wept that night. And all the children of Israel murmured against Moses, against Aaron. And all the congregation said unto them, "We God that we should die in this wilderness." But the Bible says, what the people said cannot stand. They plan evil against Moses. They conspire evil against Moses. Because the Lord have called Moses for a special purpose. Brother, your existence is not ordinary. The Lord called you for a special purpose. The Lord called you for a supernatural program. Therefore, any evil that organized against you shall not stand. The people of Israel that the people was leading, they organized against Moses. The Bible said, it will never stand. Even Moses was praying for God to forgive them. God said, their evil will never stand. Now that shall it come to pass. Therefore, any man or woman or witches or wizard that plan evil against you this month, their evil will never stand. Their conspiracy will never stand. Their plans and program over your life will never stand. Whatever the devil decide over your case will never stand. Because the Bible said it shall come to pass on that day. Now listen, the one they give back to Jesus, the book of Matthew chapter 2, let's go to the Bible again. They give back to Jesus. And Herod was there that time. Then Herod organized. That Jesus Christ should be arrested, should be killed. For God said it shall not stand, neither shall it come to pass. God said it shall never stand, neither shall it come to pass. Now, the book of Matthew chapter 2, excuse me, the book of Matthew chapter 2 from verse 1. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east of Jerusalem. East of Jerusalem. Say, where is he that he was born? That is born in the Jews. For we have seen the star of the east. In the east. And are come to worship him. And when Herod the king had those things, he was troubled. And all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes and people together, he demanded them where Christ should be born. Every evil they tried to conspire because of your existence, the Bible said it will never stand, neither shall it come to pass. The Bible said it will never stand, neither shall it come to pass. All the people that are watching your star, watching your star in order to fight against your life, not to fight against your future, not to fight against your progress. The Bible said those things will never stand, neither shall it come to pass. During the time of Jesus, every battle that was gathered against him was collapsed completely. Those evil, God disorganized all of them. Because the Bible says, surely they will surely gather. But every gathering that thought of God must scatter. Therefore, God cannot support any evil against you. God cannot support every disaster against you. Only be that strong. Only be that strong in prayer. Only be that strong in following the Lord. Don't be discouraged. Don't look back. Don't look back. Don't wait. The Lord is going to promote you. Remember, the Bible said in the book of James chapter 2, the book of James, he said, you must stand firm in the Lord. You must start to follow him. And the Lord is going to see you through. The Bible says again, the book of James chapter 5 verse 4. He said, if you lack wisdom, you should ask God, who give liberally. The book of James chapter 1 from verse 5. If you lack wisdom, you should ask God, he will give you. And the same Bible says, and if you ask, don't ask in wavering. Don't waver. Don't shake. No matter what is going on, start the faith and you will see the glory of God. So what I'm talking about tonight, that all the evil standing against you will never stand. Any evil following your life, following your star, following your glory, following your future, they will never stand. Now that shall it come to pass. Now listen. And they said from verse 4, the book of Matthew chapter 2 from verse 4, when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes and people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem the Judea, for thou is written by the prophet, and thou Bethlehem in the land of Judea, thou art the least among the princes of the Judah, for out of thee shall come out a governor that shall rule my people Israel. And Herod, when he had prevailed, called the wise men, he inquired of them diligently, with what time did the star appear? Any power that tries to search your star will never stand in the name of Jesus. Any power searching for your star will never stand in the name of Jesus. Because the Bible said it shall not stand. It shall not stand. Any power trying to stand up against you will never stand. Anything that tries to stand up against your glory will never stand. The Bible said it shall not stand. And Herod decided to inquire and find out diligently. Now let's see verse 13. When they were departed, when the wise men departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in the dream, saying, arise, take the young child and his mother, flee into Egypt, be thou there until I bring thee the word. For Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. Because of your prosperity, because of your favor, because of your glory, because of your fame, because of your investment, because of your marriage, because of your wife, because of your husband, because of your children, and they are seeking for your life to destroy you. But the Bible said those who seek it will never stand. The Bible said it will never stand. They will never stand. It shall never stand. And that shall it come to pass. Those that battle with you. The Bible said God told Mary and Joseph, carry this child into Egypt. The reason why God moving you to another city or moving close your business and leave this place, you must understand that Joseph is a carpenter. Joseph will have a carpenter shop where he's building doors, frames, so many things. But God asked him, close this shop, move to another city. At times you are blaming God. At times you are crying, you are complaining. I have been praying and paying my tithe, give offering, do everything I want to do in order for me to make it. I have been paid, I have not failed God one day. Why should this happen to me? But the point is, he doesn't understand the God's program in your life. The point is, he doesn't understand God's program in your life or God's plan over your life, God's plan over your business. Because people want to kill you, people planning to destroy your life. Let me tell you the spiritual principle. When Abraham was asking God, where is my blessing? God said, there are people that are in charge of that blessing. I have a covenant with them. I cannot do anything now until after 400 years. I have covenant with them to operate for 400 years. And Herod was there. God cannot kill Herod that time. Because God have covenant with Herod to rule for some years before he can kill Herod and usher Jesus back to Judea. So, there are people that are pursuing your life. There are people who want to kill you. There are people who want to destroy you. There are people who want to frustrate you. There are people who want to eliminate your future. There are people who don't want to see you. But at times, God said, close this business. And all the customers that are supposed to betray that business, he would draw them back. Business go down where everything God knows about it. Don't say God doesn't know. He is so many presents. He is so many signs. God knew everything. That the reason why God wants you to move to another place. So that power that is pursuing you will never stand. Let me deal with him. Yes, let me deal with that power. God wants to deal with those powers. Yes, so that's why the Bible said the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, from verse 19 and 20. He said, those that oppress you, those that make shame of you, make mockery of you, I will make your name famous in their presence. How? God told Elijah, go and stay in a cave so that a bird will feed you. From there to Zarephath woman, From there to the mountain, and Elijah show up again. Or now, or Sotomaqua, another time. Or swear again. Are you hearing me? So what am I talking about? When God tells you to say, like, there is time for everything here on earth. When you relax, it doesn't mean that you are not there. When you are relaxed, it doesn't mean that you are not there. You are relaxing, but something is there. The Bible said Jesus Christ was relaxing inside the boat. But the waves started pushing, pushing, and the apostles called him. He said, don't you care that we perish? He said, he stood up and rebuked the waves. You are still powerful. You are still who you are. You have not changed. God is still made you who you are. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Even when Elisha died, Elisha was buried, and somebody that was dead dropped on the grave of Elijah, and the person was resurrected. You are still who you are. Nobody can take away your glory from you. Nobody can take away your star from you. But God told Mary and Joseph, lie low. Close that your shop, lie low. Close that your business, lie low. I have a program to deal with this one that pursue you. All those that are pursuing you this month, the Lord will search for them. God will close their file. God will close their chapter. God will close their chapter in the mighty name of Jesus. Now let's go to the Bible again. The book of 2 Kings. The book of 2 Kings chapter 19. You know, at times when the pastors ask you to put a prayer request, write your prayer request. You begin to imagine, why should I write a prayer request? For what? Why prayer request? God will read the letters. Maybe you don't understand. I will show you where God will read the letter. God will read the letter A, B, C, D, E, F. He read it completely. Now let's go to the Bible. The book of 2 Kings chapter 19 from verse 14. Hezekiah received the letter of the hand of the messengers and read it. Hezekiah went up into the house of the Lord and spread it before the Lord and said, God, you read this letter. See what I have wrote unto me. Any power that I will show you in full dream in this night, the Lord is going to visit their camp in Jesus' name. Agent of darkness that I will show you in full dream, those that I will get to you in the dream and show you accident, show you sudden death, show you premature death, show you shame, show you disgrace, show you humiliation, that this is what is going to happen to you. This night, the Lord is going to visit their camp. If they see tomorrow morning, thank God, they will not see it. But let's see. Verse 15. And Hezekiah prayed before the Lord and said, O Lord God, which dwelleth between the cherubim, thou art God, even thou alone, of all the kings of the earth. Now listen, from verse, let's go for it. Hezekiah was praying, praying, praying until Hezekiah get to 33. Hezekiah get to verse 30. And Hezekiah was praying that prayer until Hezekiah go down to chapter 31. For out of Jerusalem shall go forth a remnant. For thy escape of the out of them, Isaiah, the zeal of the Lord shall comfort thee. Verse 32. Thus said the Lord God concerning the king of Assyria, who wrote the letter. He shall not come into this city. He shall never stand. He can never come to this city, nor shoot an arrow there, nor come before with the shield, nor cast a bar against it. By the way that they came, the same way shall they return. He shall not come near to this city, says the Lord. For I will defend this city to save it for my own sake, for my servant David's sake. Verse 35. It came to pass the same night that the angel of the Lord went out and smote the camp of the Assyrians, and the 104,000, when the 5,000 was dead. When they woke up early in the morning, behold, all of them was dead. So they wrote a letter to Hezekiah that is going to deal with Hezekiah, they're going to kill him. What am I talking about? They do the same thing to Jesus. That the Herod was looking for Jesus, and God deal with Herod that night. Therefore, this day again, and God also, they wrote letter to Hezekiah, and God said, thus says the Lord, it shall never come to pass, neither shall it come to stand. Therefore, for this reason, all the evil news you had over your life, If good news you had over your business, if good news you had over your glory, it will never stand. Now that shall come to pass. It will never stand. All devil will never stand. Bad news will never stand. Yes, the Bible says in the book of Job, chapter 22, from verse 29, when men are being cast down, thou shalt say, men are rising up, and God will lift you up. He's going to lift you up. Therefore, for this reason, you are not allowed to shake. You are not allowed to complain. I want to tell you something tonight, that if you can stand firm before the Most High God and declare who you are, keep on calling upon the living God for vengeance, and the Lord is going to show up, and he will defend you in the name of Jesus. I want to pray to tonight that all the evil that I'm assigned over your life will never stand in the name of Jesus. Evil that I will program over your destiny will never stand in the name of Jesus. Evil that I'm assigned to follow your life will never stand in the name of Jesus. The Bible said those that are standing up against you shall stumble and fall in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible said he will slay the wicked in the darkness. The wicked shall be slain in the darkness in the mighty name of Jesus. The people that they conspired to throw missiles and Abednego in the burning fire, they couldn't stand. The fire burned them. And the Judas Iscariot organized to betray Jesus, and the where he planned to hang Jesus, he couldn't stand. The person accepted his life. Therefore, whatever evil anybody organized against you this October, this evil will visit his house in Jesus' name. The Bible said in the book of 2 Thessalonians, mark my word, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 6, it is one of the righteousness of God. It is a righteous thing with God to return tribulation to them that troubles you. So anyone that organizes tribulation to your life, God is a righteous thing with God. It's a righteous program to carry the tribulation back to sender. Therefore, for this reason, every tribulation organized against your business will never stand. Every tribulation organized against your marriage will never stand in the name of Jesus. Every tribulation organized against your investment will never stand. Every tribulation organized where you are building house will never stand. Every tribulation organized against where you are traveling will never stand. Tribulation set up in the dream over your life will never stand. In the mighty name of Jesus, this month of October, the Lord will not tolerate anyone troubling your life. The Bible says in the book of Numbers chapter 14 from verse 22, these people have provoked God for so long time. And God said he will disinherit them. For this reason, God said he will show vengeance. They did this thing for 10 times. And this is the 9 times God kept quiet. This is the 10th time. 10th day of the month or 10th days or 10th month is a supernatural principle before the Lord. God cannot spare anybody who crosses his territory. He went to Egypt and told the Pharaoh, let my people go. And Pharaoh said, no. On the 10th time, God retaliate. This is the 10th month. Although I have caged you in a cage, that's why I set up a program that coming up on the 10th of this month, that is 10-10. 10th of this month to 14th of this month. That's why I set up a program that said, lose him and let him go. Therefore, wherever they have tied your life, wherever they have tied your destiny, they can never continue. The Lord will terminate that program in the mighty name of Jesus. They have been mocking the life of Moses, mocking. It came to pass. The Bible said these people will not stand again. I must make sure that I close the chapter. This is the month of October. That is the 10th day of this month. 10th of this month, God is going to show himself. The Bible said the book of Luke chapter 21 verse 22. He said, without vengeance, everything written about you will not be fulfilled. If I plan for promotion, if I plan for success, if I plan for joy, if I plan for happiness, without vengeance, it cannot be fulfilled. This month, the Bible said, lose him and let him go. Yes, all the evil over your life will never stand. Sickness will never stand this month. Frustration will never stand this month. Humiliation will never stand this month. Disgrace will never stand this month. Tuberculosis will never stand this month. Arthritis will never stand this month. Backwardness will never stand this month. Cancer of the brain will never stand this month. Cancer of the breast will never stand this month. Cancer in the will never stand this month. Any evil pronouncement will never stand this month. The Bible says, Samuel walked with the Lord. His word did not follow the ground. But all the evil pronouncements over your life, this month, all of them will fall on the ground. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, I thank you, Jehovah. I bless your holy name. I give you praise. Thank you because you're a mighty and wonderful Father. I pray that every one of you that are watching this program will never remain the same. These prayers I pray tonight, the Lord will use it to promote you. Now, I want to program prayer over your life. I want to program prayer. I want to program prayer over your life. The Bible says, the book of Joshua chapter 6 verse 26. Joshua prayed a prayer in the Jericho and the walls of Jericho collapsed. He made a declaration. Whosoever that will raise up this wall that was go down, his first son will die. If we put the foundation, his first son will die. After putting the foundation put together, his last son will die. Let's see whether the word of God functions. In the book of 1 Kings chapter 16 verse 34, hear the Bethelite went and put the foundation without knowing that there was a cause. As he put the foundation there, his first son who died. He put the gate, his last son died. According to the word of God pronounced by Joshua. So, which means the time bomb is the word of God. I want to program time bomb over your life tonight. That as you listen to this message, any witches that rise up against you again will carry your problem in Jesus' name. Yes. The Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 verse 15, all the diseases of Egyptians don't even know about it. I will lay it upon the people that hate you. Therefore, for this reason, any witches that hate you after listening to this message and they try to attack you again, all the problems you have, God will give it to them in Jesus' name. As you listen to this message, every witches and wizard that try to block your business, if they try it again, problem following your life will follow them in Jesus' name. As you listen to this message, any power that is visiting you in the dream, try to humiliate you, oppress you, feed you, make you to swim in the river, having intercourse with you, as you listen to this message, if they try it again, every problem in your bone, problem in your chest, problem in your body, family problem you are passing through, God will transfer you to their life. In the mighty name of Jesus. This is what the Bible said. Deuteronomy 7:15. All the problem you don't know about, problem that is for Egypt that are used to torment Egyptians, I will give it to people that hate you. Therefore, whosoever that doesn't want you to see testimony this month of October, that doesn't want you to testify, doesn't want you to see your testimony, doesn't want you to have your testimony, doesn't want you to have what you are looking for, doesn't want you to laugh this much, that want on this road to follow you. Whatever sickness in your blood, sickness in your gene, family sickness, family disease, family disaster, family poverty, we follow those who are in the name of Jesus. Whoever blocking your way, the Lord will block their way in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, the same way they come, they shall go back. Therefore, for this reason, any evil that are assigned to follow you because you hear this message. The Bible says, the book of Matthew 13, from verse 19, when anyone heareth the word of the kingdom, understandeth it not, but cometh the wicked ones, and to take it away. He said, but when tribulation and persecution arises because of the word, by and by they will be offended. Therefore, for this reason, whoever that wants to take a persecution to take away this message you are hearing this night, what the Bible says, the same way they come, so shall they go back. As they try to come to attack you because of this message, the Lord will chase them away in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 18 verse 14, he will shut his arrow and the lightning and discomforted them. Anyone that wants to attack you because you hear this message, whoever that attack you because you listen to this Bible, whoever that want to attack you because you are hearing the word of God, and Father God will see, ready, release lightning and use to discomfort and scatter them in Jesus' name. Therefore, this month of October, whatever you have been searching for, you will get it in Jesus' name. The Bible said the book of Numbers. Yes, the book of Numbers, chapter 14. He said to Moses, these people have provoked me this time. From verse 28, he says, they say to my own hearing, I will do it unto them. This month of October, any evil, anybody pronounce over his mouth into your life, God will do it to him in the name of Jesus. This is what the Bible said, number 14:28. As long as they say this to my own hearing, I will do it to them. Anybody who curses you this month, God will give him that curse. Anybody who harasses you this month, God will harass him. Whoever that has frustrated you this month, God will frustrate him. Whoever block your way this month, God will block his way. Whatever they are trying to give you this month, God will collect it and give it to them. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says it is a righteous thing with God to the talk to the to them that troubles you. I declare that they can never stand. No evil that will stand before you this month. No witches that will stand. No declaration of the witches shall stand. No evil of the witches shall stand. Every agenda of the devil will never stand. Come to this program, brother. They come to this program on this 10th day of this month. The Lord is going to do something. He said, lose him and let him go. Lose him and let him go. Nobody can stand. All the things that have been tying you will never stand. Witches and wizards that tying you will never stand. Because this month the Lord will release you. It's a month of freedom. It's a month of liberation. Come and be blessed. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will increase you. Remember, I tell you, on the 10th of this month, which is Wednesday, by 6 o'clock we are here, which is on Thursday, 6 o'clock, Friday, 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock every day, on Saturday, the 7th, until Sunday, on our Ozzy, you come here and see God in action. Yes, come with happiness, come with expectation. The Lord is going to bless you mightily. The man of God that is coming is well loaded. I have to pray for this man of God. The Bible said in the book of Isaiah chapter 28. Yes, the book of Isaiah chapter 28. The Bible said, from verse 6, it said, when a man sit in the seat of judgment, the spirit of judgment will rest upon him. If this man of God carry microphone, the spirit of freedom will rest upon him. Anything he said over your life, or you will see it. As he opened his mouth, yes. The Bible said, he that sits in the seat of judgment, spirit of judgment will rest upon him. And he that carry battle to the gate, strength will give in to him. Therefore, if this man of God carry mic and fix your life, the strength to overcome the witches and wizards will come upon his life. Every witch in your life will vacate. The strength to overcome all the curses in your life will come upon him. Every curses will be destroyed. The Bible said, test and see that the Lord is good. Come on this program. You never remain the same. The Lord bless you. Yes, and the man that God is using powerfully on this program is telling us that during that program, everybody is going to appear on the YouTube. Your family will watch you when you are dancing and glorifying God. They will know that you don't play game in Spain. They will know that you don't play game in abroad. People, your family will see you. Just come with expectation. Come with the happiness. The Lord is going to bless you. I cover your life this day with the blood of Jesus. You will never remain the same. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you.